Hello and welcome to Azure Wala YouTube channel. We are in part 51 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 87 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 88. You have two Azure subscriptions named Sub1 and Sub2. An administrator creates a custom role that has an assignable scope to resource group name RG1 in subscription 1. You need to ensure that you can apply custom role to any resource group in subscription 1 and subscription 2. The solution must minimize administrative efforts. What should you do? To understand this question or visualize this question properly, let's go to a diagram. As per our question, we have subscription 1 and subscription 2 in Azure, and there is one resource group called resource group 1 in subscription 1. It has a custom role assigned by one of the administrator. So that is right now applied on resource group 1 under the subscription 1, and we need to make sure that this custom role which is applied on resource group 1 can be applied on any resource group in subscription 1 and subscription 2. That means that we can apply on whatever available resource group in both the subscriptions, so all the resource groups. Therefore, the best solution is that we may apply on the subscription level this one, and that will automatically be applied on all the resource groups in subscription 1 and subscription 2. Further, if we apply the custom role on all the resource groups through subscriptions, means we apply on subscription 1 and subscription 2, it will reduce the administrative efforts needed. Otherwise, if we are going one by one to apply on each and every resource, it will have more administrative effort needed. Let's go back to question. Let's see the option. Option D. Select the custom role and add subscription 1 to assignable scope. Remove the resource group 1 from the assignable scope. Create a new custom role for subscription 2. This solution will work, but it would require two different custom roles, so it has more efforts needed to manage both the custom roles on subscription 1 and subscription 2. Therefore, it would not be suitable. But let's see option C. Create a new custom role in subscription 1 and add subscription 2 to assignable scopes. Remove the role from RG1. Creating a new custom role is not needed here, since we do have custom role available and we just need to change the assignable scope here. So that also would not be a good idea to create a new custom role. Let's see the option B. Create a new custom role. Again, it is asking to create a new custom role, which is not needed because we do have custom role in place and we just need to change the scope, assignable scope here. Let's see the option A. Select the custom role. That's the correct option here, because we need to select existing custom role and add it to subscription 1 and subscription 2, which is the correct action here, because if we apply on subscription 1, it will be applicable to all the resource groups in subscription 1, and if we apply to subscription 2, it will be applicable on all the resource groups on the subscription 2 as well. To assignable scope, remove the resource group 1 which is already assigned in this question, so we will remove this from the assignable scope and we'll put the subscription 1, so anyway it will cover the resource group 1 as well. So this is the correct answer. Therefore, creating a new custom role is not needed. That's why B is incorrect, C is incorrect. And select the custom role and add to this one, and remove resource group 1 and create new custom role. This part was incorrect in option D. So I hope this is clear for this question. Let's move to next question. Question number 89. You have the following custom role based access control role, and definition is a JSON definition here. So before we read this JSON stuff, let's see what question is asking about. So we'll scroll down and go to answer area. So first statement is, users that are assigned role 1 can assign role 1 to users, means other users. We have to check from that JSON which is provided above, that if users whoever assign this role can assign other users the same role. Let's scroll up to see. And so we have to work with the authorization here. We know the scope here, that is applied to subscription, and we'll go to action items. If we can see, we can read all the authorization here. Authorization star read permission is there, and other than that there is nothing related to authorization is available in actions. Let's see in the not action area that we do have authorization star delete. So this is not action area, it means it is not going to permit this one. In this permission we cannot delete anything on authorization, and we cannot write anything in the authorization as well. Therefore the statement, first statement answer would be no, because we have denial permission or not action permission on the authorization in this case. So we cannot write anything on the authorization, therefore we cannot assign any role to other users. Let's see statement 2. Statement 2 says, users that are assigned role 1 can deploy new virtual machine. We have to check related to virtual machine or compute part. So we'll go to action items here, and we can see compute is starting from here. Users who have this role assigned can start, can power off, can deallocate, can restart, and can do everything with the virtual machine. So therefore the user who have this role assigned can deploy new virtual machine as well. So everything with the virtual machine, that user has the permission here. So the answer would be yes in this case. We'll scroll down, and the second statement answer is yes. Next statement is, users that are assigned role 1 can set a static IP address on the virtual machine. So setting the static IP address is the networking job, and it has to have some network interface related permission on this. So we'll quickly go up again and check the action items, that if we do have any network related permissions. So network, virtual network subnet join action we can do, network virtual network subnet read action we can do, subnet virtual machines read action we can do, and on the network interface we can do everything. So we can assign network interface card static or dynamic IPs which is associated with any virtual machine. So in answer area we'll go, and therefore the answer for third statement would be yes. Second statement we already know it was yes, and first statement it was no. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, and press the bell notification icon. Also share with your friends. Thank you for watching this video. See you in next video.